Hello and welcome to ADS or to Inform. My name is Frank Massey. I'd like to welcome you to this part two PICO training forum. You may recall in the part one PICO filming tutorial we did some time ago, we touched upon the subject of trying to evaluate engine efficiency and mechanical performance using the oscilloscope. In this module, we're going to develop that process and in some detail. I had some reservations, and still do have some reservations, about the accuracy of being able to establish or predict where the camshaft actually is in relation to the four-stroke cycle. Now, I've put some thought to this, and I'd like to introduce a series of tests which will build what I believe into a very accurate assessment. We're going to do something rather interesting, not just looking at the cam and crank angle sensor, but introducing pressure measurement. And I'd like to explain in some detail my personal thoughts on interpretation of pressure measurement. So that's the module. A little bit of preparation will be needed between each of the filming sessions, but I'd like to now introduce the first part by taking perhaps a step back, and I'd like you to I've got a particular belief in how we should view pressure within an engine during the four-stroke cycle. Now, to do this, I'd like just to use the flip chart. We generally use and accept an expression called suction or vacuum. I'd like you to accept on face value initially, and I hope you adopt it once I've explained my view on this, there is no such thing as vacuum or suction. I'd like to suggest that we, on the face of this planet, exist at generally plus, it changes with altitude of course, but plus 1 bar of pressure. If we leave the environment of our planet, we accept that the pressure is zero. And I think to confirm this, the MAP sensor is something we use and accept as an accurate measurement of engine load. And just think of the terminology. Manifold absolute pressure. I made the expression, there is no such thing as suction or vacuum. If we accept that this is absolute zero and we exist at 1 bar, then this is actually a pressure. Granted, it is lower than atmosphere, but it is still a pressure. Now, the reason I want you to accept that is that when you've got a differential in pressure in this area here, which exists at certain periods during the four-stroke cycle, and that there is a differential between pressure above atmosphere, what it actually introduces is flow. Now, that flow can be airflow, it can be fluid flow, but the greater the differential, the greater the flow. And if we accept that, that this is pressure, not suction or vacuum, and there's a differential of pressure between that above atmosphere and below atmosphere, then I think we can then better understand what's happening in the cylinder when the piston is either accelerating up the bore or accelerating down the bore. So that's something we need to perhaps accept before we go into the process of the test we're going to do.